G'day, welcome back to Build Some, and the 10th presentation in the series on the tip of framing code. So now that we've calculated our spans for our ceiling joists, we can work out exactly what rooms we actually need hanging beams in. So hanging beams are used when the ceiling joists don't span the distance required. So you can see here, this is a plan of our top plates, and I've put in the necessary dimensions to work out the information we need. So there's our ceiling joists, and you can see these two end rooms, they're running left to right here and here, and the rest of the house, they're running up and down the screen. Okay, so these joists are spanning 2.5 meters, these joists here are spanning 3.5 meters, the joists on this side of the house are spanning 3.5 meters, except for the few in the entryway here, which are 2.4, and all the joists on this side of the house are spanning 3.5 metres. You'll notice that most of the joists are single span, because they're joined here, and they sit on the wall. The only ones that are continuous span at the moment are the ones sitting on this wall here, because they're continuous from that wall over to this wall. So now let's have a look at our spans for our ceiling joists. So our single span that we're allowed to have is 1700, so none of our joists are spanning less than 1700, so we're not going to have any single spans in this house at all. The distance we're allowed to have for a continuous span is 2.2, so even here, this was continuous, that distance there is greater than 2.2. So we're going to have a hanger in virtually all of our rooms. So I'll just show you that. So I've put a hanger in each of our rooms. So now these joists are spanning half of our 2500, so 1250, and that's well and truly under our continuous span limit. These joists here are spanning half of our 3500, so that's 1700, again less than our continuous span distance. So now that I've put in a hanger over all those positions, all of our joists are spanning under our maximum continuous span of 2200. So that means that every room in this house is going to require a hanging beam, and we'll look at working out the size of the hanging beams in the next video, but now we know where we actually need them and what rooms we need them in.